Greetings. More reasons to reject Islam. Reason number two, Islam is deathly afraid of Bible prophecy. I'm serious. Here is the interesting thing about it. If you talk to any Mohammedans today, they will tell you the Torah and Bible are corrupted. So corrupted they are not trustworthy. But if they really believed it was corrupted, they would not fear anything in it. So what exactly am I saying they are afraid of? Ezekiel chapter 44 verse 1. Then he brought me back the way of the gate of the outward sanctuary which looketh toward the east, and it was shut. This passage is speaking of a gate to the Temple Mount, specifically a gate facing toward the east. So it happens to be called the East Gate. Then saith the Lord unto me, This gate shall be shut, it shall not be opened, and no man shall enter in by it, because the Lord, the God of Israel, has entered in by it, therefore it shall be shut. This is a prophecy speaking of this eastern gate. It will be shut and considered holy because God will have entered in through it. It is for the prince. The prince, he shall sit in it to eat bread before the Lord. The prince is the son of the king. But here, in this prophecy, the prince means the son of God. Now, the East Gate existed from the time of prophet Ezekiel. The East Gate even existed during the time of Jesus. And the East Gate existed during the lifetime of Muhammad, the founder of Islam. And the East Gate existed during the reign of Ottoman Sultan Suleiman I. I call him Suleiman the Silly Man, but more accurately, Suleiman the Scared. How can I call this man, the Sultan, scared? It's easy. The Sultan, the world leader of Islam, was no doubt an educated man. And even if he were not personally educated, he no doubt had advisors. Advisors who would have said, Sultan, the Jewish scriptures foretell God will enter Jerusalem. Prophet Ezekiel has foretold God would enter through the East Gate. Tell me, does this East Gate even exist? Yes, great Sultan, it exists in Jerusalem. Tell me, what can be done to stop the Jewish God? We can destroy the Temple Mount, great one. No good. I just had the dome repainted. We could close it, fill it in with bricks. No. We must close it. Fill it in with bricks. Excellent, Your Excellency. And that is exactly what this poor, stupid pagan ordered to be done. I mean, seriously, can you ever think that bricks could stop Almighty God? So Suli Silly Scaredy Man, the Sultan, had the Eastern Gate bricked up. And this is how the East Gate exists to this very day. Here's one picture of it. Here's another picture from a different angle showing you the golden atrocity. And here's a third picture. I think this last picture shows it best. Kind of a dumb place to put a gate, right? It does not appear to go anywhere. But that is actually another example of the fear and stupidity of Islam. Another passage of prophecy says that Prophet Elijah will return before the Lord. Micah 4:5, Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And there is also another scripture which might have scared Suleiman. Prophet Isaiah foretells of one prophet leading and preparing the way for the Lord. Isaiah 43, The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, Prepare ye the way of the Lord, Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Now, men of discernment know this refers to John the Baptist, who announced Messiah. And men of understanding know that this is more proof that Jesus is Yahweh, the Lord God. But this video is examining how Islam misreads the text, causing fear and stupid behavior. Not only did they brick up the East Gate, but they thought they could stop a prophet of God by putting a cemetery outside the gate. You got it. These are row after row of gravestones. Can you begin to grasp how stupid Islam is? The prophet of the God who raises the dead is supposed to be frightened by a cemetery. It is really hard to come up with a more concrete, or dare I say brick, example of just how dumb Islam is. Islam thinks bricks in a gate will stop Almighty God. Islam thinks a cemetery is so filthy that no prophet can pass through it. Islam simply is stupid. And that is a great reason to reject Islam. Oh, Muslim, you are tricked and lied to that Muhammad's religion is a true path. It is not. Following Islam made Suleiman stupid. There is so much more to even say on this topic alone. Why try to stop the prophet of God leading the Lord himself to return? Who is the spirit that opposes God? Why rebel against the prophets of God? Why rebel against their message? Oh, Muslim, I cry out for you to think, brothers. I am showing you the truth. Islam is afraid. Why be afraid, O Muslim, if your Allah is greater? You know in your heart why. It is the same reason you are afraid to read the Word of God. Muhammad's religion is a religion of fear. Muhammad's religion controls you with fear. But I have the good news for you, O Muslim brother. The true Injil came to set you free from fear. 1 John 4:18, there is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear has torment. He that fears is not made perfect in love. You see, God is love, O Muslim. Suleiman feared because he did not know God. And his fear made him do stupid things to defend his religion, Islam. So Islam fears prophecies in the Bible, and therefore I reject Islam. Forever. Make no mistake, Islam has good reason to fear. Bricks will no more stop Almighty God than a cemetery or angry shouts of Allahu Akbar. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who is going to return and enter through the East Gate. And bricks will never stop him. Amen.